this Mother's Day. It's my privilege to lead us in a time of communion now. So I'm just thinking about my mum, and I'm glad she's not watching. She's at church somewhere else, so she won't hear what I say. But I was a naughty kid. I was so naughty. I remember her breaking a wooden spoon on my backside once, and I asked her about it recently, and she didn't even remember that. She was horrified. But she did lots of positive things in my life too. I don't remember all of them. It kind of frustrates me a little bit. I wonder how many of you have lost your glasses. I have a habit of asking my daughter Naomi, where are my glasses? I can't find my glasses. On your head, Dad. Where are my keys? I lose my keys 10 times a day. I put things down. I can't find them. I'm really forgetful. I'm sure that plenty of you can relate. And if you think about it, true relationship relies on memory. Because I guess any of those who have dealt with dementia in your family know that relationship becomes harder when memory fades. And if I think back through my testimony and the miracles that God's done in my life, years ago I could have given you all of the details, but now not so much. I can give you some, but it kind of fades a bit, and that frustrates me. And the Bible tells me, I want to talk a little bit about the concept of memorials, not in the sense of death and someone's passed away, so don't think about it like that. Memorials, which we can define as to remember and to tell the story again. And there's a lot of this concept in the Old Testament. The Bible tells us memorials are important because he knows that we're forgetful, just like his chosen people. They were often focused on the here and now, on themselves, rather than God's long history with them. Probably one of the most well-known concepts of a memorial is the Passover. So the Hebrews they witnessed all the supernatural things that God, the plagues that God brought down on the Egyptians, and God gave very specific instructions for how they were to survive that Passover night. And in Exodus 14:11, I think it is, he says, "This is to be a memorial for you. You must celebrate it as a festival to the Lord. You are to celebrate it throughout your generations as a permanent statute." And only a few days later, after this fearful display of God's power, they're at the Red Sea. Still not very trusting of God. The Egyptian army's bearing down on them. And in Exodus 14:11, listen for the sarcasm in this. They ask Moses, "Was there not enough graves in Egypt that you brought us out to take us away and die in the wilderness? Why didn't you leave us where we were?" And there's many other examples. Joshua, when God parted the Jordan, he said to the Israelites, "Build a cairn of stones." So why? So you can tell your children what happened here. They can tell their children. And one generation later, they've forgotten all about God again. So because of our short memory, I believe that God really wants us to embrace this concept of memorials. Even today, most people on earth celebrate a memorial of Jesus' birth and his death and resurrection, aka Christmas and Easter. So it's really important that we remember the lengths that God's gone to redeem us and bring us back into relationship with him. And one of the most important memorials central to our faith is the one Jesus gave us in Luke 22. It says, "And this in remembrance of me. In the same way, he also took the cup after supper. He said, this is the cup, which is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. So as we celebrate the memorial of communion this morning, my prayer is that we would all be reminded of just how much God loves us and the lengths Jesus went to in laying down his life for us. So if you'd like to, if you're at home, just grab whatever's handy. But for us here, there's tables up the front and the back if you'd like to just come and help yourselves to a bit of cracker and juice in a minute. I'll just pray and then you can take it in your own time. So Heavenly Father, we thank you for Jesus' body, which was broken for us. We thank you for his blood, which was spilled out for us. This is the blood of your new covenant, and we thank you for the sacrifice you made for us. Help us to always remember and to tell the story.